Hello, good morning. You're watching Proactive London. Panther Metals has received a renewal of its permit to explore the Dotted Lake project in Canada. Darren Hazlewood is joining us early this morning here because we're going to talk about what this new permit will allow you to do exactly, Darren. If you could explain it to us.
Yeah, good morning, Katie. Thanks for having us on this morning. Yeah, the permit, we had a permit in place, but we felt it limited our upside potential in the area. And so this new permit at Dotted, it allows us to drill up to 8 holes and just to extend the work program, should we require it following the initial drill hole that we're going to do. That'll be 400 meters deep. That this is really, the drill hole itself is more a look at the stratigraphy of the area. The stratigraphy is the layers of the rock in geological terms. We're very much encouraged by the results that we've seen to our east and west of Dotted Lake, and we believe this sits along the same fault, same system. We're drilling into a known gold zone that we confirmed historic data from. We confirmed the historic data in work program that took place in September, and the results come out last autumn. So yeah, it really enables us to advance forward here, and we're financed to be able to do this as well, and we're financed to be able to take it to the next stage. So it's exciting times.
Financed and ready to take it to the next stage. In regards to currently engaging with potential contractors with a view to drill at the earliest opportunity, how's that going?
It's going very well. We're literally at the stage of collating quotes and then engaging with them, and at that stage we'll know where we're at, we'll know timings, and as soon as I've got that, which I don't envisage being a long time at all, I'll update the market accordingly.
Sounds good. Tell us what's going on at Big Bear.
Right, so we've put in for an additional drill licenses in two separate areas. The northern section really intrigues us. It's thrown up some fascinating stuff from the mag data that we conducted last year. And it's an area that we've always had an eye on. It's not too far from the Little Bear mine that produced over 1,500 grams a ton gold from a sample in the 1930s. And we've decided to cover off that now because we are still waiting on the permit applications that we put in last year. So effectively, whilst we can continue our exploration programs on the ground, we decided to sort of get ahead of the game here to enable us to cover. And in the south, we've got the Jeddah area, and that's got two historic mines on it. It's got some exceptionally high grade historically. And we're talking about well above 200 grams a ton. There was actually a sort of single guy producing mine there until the early 90s. And again, it's another area that has never had the exploration that these results warrant. And again, we'll be out there as soon as we can, as soon as we get these permits in.
Sounds good. So a busy few months ahead where you're just focusing on these exploration activities, right?
Oh, absolutely. Look, Canada's built on mining, and we're in the right zones. We've seen these areas all around us explode because there's suddenly eyes on the ground there, and people have advanced in, and the land banks around us now vast. But fortunately, we were in there first. We were able to get the land that we wanted, and we're now going to be able to really extend the exploration work. Look, we've got no financial burden in Australia now. That's all gone. In fact, this year, there's no cost associated to Australia. And the work's gone on over there. That's all down to the subco now. So our eyes are 100% on our two assets in Canada, in Ontario. And that's what we're doing. And that's why we're now pushing ahead.
Sounds good. Darren Hazlewood, thank you very much from Panther Metals here on Proactive this morning.
Thanks for having me on, Katie.